is the Z-Files on the road in the Trump Coliseum. You might as well name it after him, folks. As I look around the room, every seat is already filled. It's 45 minutes till the show begins, and you can hear the crowd being warmed up and made excited about coming here for this event. This is the Z-Files special on location. We'll have an interview on our program that you'll hear on the radio version of this with Denise DeZozo, which we did on the radio at the studio on Friday morning. We interviewed Mr. DeSouza on Friday morning in our studio, but that'll be for our radio listeners to hear on Saturday morning. Of course, the big event happens at 7. Right now, you can hear they're warming up the crowd, getting ready for us to hear from Donald Trump. He's scheduled to appear at about 7. Of course, there have already been other preliminary speakers. I'm sure there'll be some more as we go through the evening. So stay with us, folks. Well, you know, this is Friday night when Donald Trump is coming to Pensacola, Florida. This is high school football night. It's even college football night. Randy Williams right here with me from Fox Sports Radio 1490 in Milton. You're going to divide your attention between some football game in Louisville and Donald Trump?
Well, you know, sometimes you got to do what you got to do. So I've got the app to watch, keep up with football and what's going on and the scores there. And then right behind us here is where Donald Trump is going to be presenting his speech here just about, 15 minutes from now. Donald Trump.
Now, what do you think about the crowd that's here rather than being at a local football game anywhere else?
Well, you know, here's the thing. People are here. You get one chance to see Donald Trump. And here's the opportunity. It'll be twice for Pensacola. But I guarantee you, a lot of these people that are here tonight are ones that didn't attend the last event. So they're here tonight. Place is pretty much full. Capacity, and you've got people still, the sidewalks and stuff are still packed outside. They're still rolling in. A big crowd. Probably have to turn some folks away.
Now, I even see that they're starting to fill up in the very, very top levels up there. Now, you know this facility. What do you estimate the total seat capacity of Z-Files as you hear it on the radio this morning? And, of course, we'll have a lot more of it on our book thing. You can see segments of that, and you see more than what the national networks show you. They just kind of show you right close up on the there, and I do see the stands in place for the teleprompter, but we'll be able to get crowd shots and reaction to show you as well.
Thing about the event is the fact that Northwest Florida will be shown in a night, and I see all of the national news networks here, so a lot of great exposure for our area.
So, folks, won't be long now. We'll have Donald Trump, probably some other speakers on stage, and we'll see what we get. We'll video all of it, and then we'll pick what we can for the radio show, and we'll put a lot more of it up on our Cal Zethmayr and on the Good Country Facebook pages for you. So,
start spreading the news.
Thank you. So, I'm going to begin exactly where the great general left off, Donald Trump's temperament. Donald Trump has the temperament to be president of the United States. I had the great honor of working for President Ronald Reagan. And I remember they asked him once, how is the Cold War going to end? He said, they lose, we win. That's how the war against ISIS is going to end. That's how the war against radical Islamic terrorism is going to end, with a leader like Donald Trump. They lose, we win! For the last month and a half, Donald Trump has traveled the country laying out specific proposals about what he is going to do to make America great again, to be your voice in Washington, the voice of the outsiders against the insiders who have a rigged, crooked system in Washington. He's been specific about it. Meanwhile, all Hillary Clinton has done is hide engage in vicious, horrible negative ads, say horrible things about Donald Trump, and then get annoyed because Matt Lauer asked her a question about the crime she committed. She should have been in front of a grand jury, not Matt Lauer. She should be on trial now. If I did one-tenth of what she did, she laid out thousands of confidential pieces of information, I'd be in jail. She told the FBI, and it is a crime to lie to the FBI. That is the crime that Martha Stewart went to jail for. She told the FBI she didn't know what the designation C meant. She thought it had to do with capitalization. I got my first security briefing for top secret information 30 years ago. I remember what C means. It means confidential. And it was such a poor, ineffective, incompetent FBI investigation that an FBI agent handed me that investigation when I was U.S. attorney, I would have thrown it out of my office because I would have said, how come you didn't ask her, did you ever see an A or a B or a D or an F on the page? Of course she didn't. So what the heck do you think C meant? And you are lying. And you're lying when you say alphabetical. While she has been lying and lying and lying, pulling in money for the Clinton Foundation and trying to talk her way out of it, Donald Trump has been telling you he's going to lower your taxes. He's going to put more money back into your pocket. He's been speaking about substantive subjects. He is going to secure our border. He is going to throw criminal aliens out of the United States. These are specific proposals. He is going to make trade deals that are in the best interest of the United States of America and not the world. And he is going to bring back to you jobs, jobs, and more jobs. He is going to take NAFTA. And I saw him look straight in the eye of the Mexican president. He didn't blink. He didn't look like Hillary Clinton with one of those long answers. And here's the lie. He looked him straight in the eye and he said, we're going to renegotiate NAFTA. And you know what happens if they don't renegotiate? He tears it up. And you get your jobs back. On military policy, he is going to rebuild our military strength. They want us to go down to the lowest levels that we've had since World War II. In the case of the Navy, since World War I, they want to go down to 250, 240 ships. How are we going to police two oceans with so few ships? We should have 330, 340, 350 ships. That's what Donald Trump will do. And then we can stop China. Then China will look at us and they will be afraid. Now China looks at us and they say, we can push them all around the world because they are reducing their military and we can catch them. Donald Trump is going to let our soldiers slip to 420,000, not in a time in which terrorists are attacking us all over the world. He's going to build our army to 600,000. When Vladimir Putin sits down with Donald Trump, he's going to sit down with a man who has the strongest army, the strongest navy, the strongest air force, the strongest marines. the strongest special forces in the history of the world. That's called negotiating from strength. That's why he's not afraid to talk to Putin, because he can negotiate from strength. And very soon, you're going to hear that right from his mouth. I know Donald for 28 years. He is a man of integrity. He's a man of honesty. He's a plain-spoken man. And what he tells you, he will do. And I will tell you, he can out-negotiate anybody I ever met. Thank you. God bless you. And God bless America.
There are thousands of people outside that can't get in. Fantastic. Way to go. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. It is so great to be back in Florida, my second home. You know it's my second home. Thank you. Thousands of people outside cannot get in. This is what's happening. It's a movement like they have never seen before. Before we begin, let me thank our good friend, an incredible guy, Chairman Jeff Miller, for joining us here today. Thank you, Jeff. He loves our veterans, as do I, and we're working very hard. We're going to bring the veterans' care so far back. The veterans are going to love what we're doing, believe me. They're going to love it. And it's about time. It's about time. Let me open by making this very important declaration. I love this state. I love the people of this state. And together we are going to have an amazing victory on November 8th. Amazing. Decades of political failure and corruption will come swiftly to an end. And a new American future will begin November 8th. The citizens of this country will be in charge once more, and it's about time. The special interests have had their day. That chapter in our history is closing. We're going to bring back victory. We're going to bring back common sense. We're going to bring back something that the country has not had in a long, long time. We're going to start winning again. The history book is closing on the failed politicians of yesterday. A new chapter is beginning, and this chapter will be authored by you, the American people. Not me, you. This will be your time. You'll be running the show. This is a movement like they've never seen. The show is beginning. Not the donors, not the insiders, not the media executives. Very dishonest people. Right there. And with thousands of people outside, I challenge those cameras to show this arena packed. They never do. They never do. They never, ever do. These are very, very dishonest people. But you know what? We're going to bring back honesty to a lot of different facets of our life, I'll tell you right now. Go ahead. Why don't you show the arena, fellas? Why don't you turn those cameras? Why don't you do that? Go ahead. Show the arena. Once more, we will have a government of, by, and for the people. Remember that. Of, by, and for the people. All we have to do is cut our ties to the bitter failures of the past, and anything becomes possible. We have the greatest people on earth. Change is coming. All the people who've rigged the system, and we have had a rigged system, for their own personal benefit, are trying to stop our change campaign because they know that their gravy train has reached its last stop. It is your turn now. It is your time now. We've got to be smart. We've got to be tough. We've got to get out and vote. We can't let this be taken away, because this will be taken away if you don't get out and do it. We have to be smart, we have to be tough, and by the way, be very, very vigilant on November 8th. Watch what's happening. Watch what's happening. The fact that so many encrusted old political insiders oppose this incredible campaign, this incredible movement, is the best proof you will ever need that we are fighting for real change, not partisan change, not change for the donors. We're fighting for all Americans, Democrats, Republicans, independents, conservatives, liberals, even liberals, who failed us in this corrupt, corrupt, corrupt system. We're fighting for everyone who doesn't have a voice. And I will tell you, the campaign contributions coming in are unbelievable. Small donors, $61 a pop. And I'm spending my money. I am spending a fortune. I am spending a lot. I'm putting up my money. And we're being helped by small donors, and we're setting records, and we have done some job. But I will say, if we don't make it, despite what they say, if we don't make it, they're all saying it doesn't matter. What you've done has never been done before. It's one of the great phenomena. Let me tell you, if we don't make it, it's the greatest waste of time, energy, and money that I can ever think of. I will tell you, we don't make it. But we're going to make it, and polls came out today. Polls came out today where we're up in Ohio, we're up in Florida, we're up in North Carolina, up. We're up nationwide. CNN 2 days ago, up nationwide. So I just want to tell you folks, we're going to get it there. We've been abused long enough. As a country, we've been abused long enough. We're also fighting for every region of this country, for every part of Florida, and every single part of America. From Pensacola, great place, to Pittsburgh, from Baltimore to Baton Rouge, we're fighting for every last city and every last person in the country, everybody. Hillary Clinton, and you can see that from those emails, is a very dishonest candidate of the past. Ours is the campaign of the future. In this future, we're going to pursue new trade policies that put American workers first, and we're going to keep our jobs in our country. We're not going to let them take our jobs anymore, folks. We're not going to let it happen. It's been happening long enough. And the reason they don't do anything about it is because the special interests and the donors control our politicians, and they control Hillary Clinton. And it's never, ever going to happen. Take a look at New York State. When she was a senator from New York State, she campaigned by saying that she was going to bring jobs back to New York State. New York State is a disaster. She got elected, she did nothing. She said, see you later in 4 years. She got elected. Take a look at what happened to New York State. The jobs left. The jobs left. Worse than just about any place in the country. She didn't do a thing. It was all talk and no action. And that's what's going to happen here. She's all talk. She's no action. Believe me, she wouldn't know a job if it stared her in the face. I will be. I will be the greatest jobs president that God ever created. That I can tell you. And by the way, is there any place better, safer, or more fun to be than at a Trump rally, right? Right? Having a good time. So all the people who got NAFTA wrong, and by the way, signed by Bill Clinton, perhaps the worst trade deals ever made in the history, not of the country, in the history of the world. There's never been a deal so bad as NAFTA. It's a one-way highway out of this country for our jobs and for our money. And we're going to renegotiate that one very quickly, let me tell you. And then you look at what's happening with China. And they're trying to give us the Trans-Pacific Partnership now, which will be a total disaster. That Hillary Clinton called the gold standard. Barack Obama wants it. He's pressing it. It will be, and I say this, nothing can be as bad as NAFTA, but it's going to be pretty close. So I just want to tell you, we're not approving the Trans-Pacific Partnership. Just another catastrophe. Our trade deficit With the world, all this work, our trade deficit with the world is almost $800 billion a year. You think we have good negotiators? We've lost one-third of our manufacturing jobs since Bill and Hillary Clinton gave us NAFTA. China is manipulating its currency and taking our jobs. That's called cheating. And believe me, I have great relationships with China, done many deals with China, made a fortune with China, have the largest bank in the world, which is from China, as one of my tenants. They're excellent. And they just renewed their lease. I can't believe it, but they just renewed their lease. Sell lots of condos to China. We can do great with China. And I'm not blaming China. I'm blaming our leaders for being so stupid. We're going to stop companies from leaving our country and keep those jobs right here in Pensacola, but right here in America. The era of economic surrender is over. We will also have a very, very strong border. That stops people and drugs. And those drugs are poisoning our youth and poisoning our people from illegally pouring into our country. And we will build the wall, and Mexico will pay for the wall. We're losing our jobs, folks. We're losing our jobs. And it's all so easy. When a company makes product and they fire all their people in the United States and they announce they're moving, as an example, to Mexico, we have to let them know there are consequences when they think they're going to sell their product back into our country. Very simple. And when we tell them the consequences are a 35% tax to cross a now very strong border, when we become president, and the Border Patrol agents, 16,500 endorsed Donald Trump. They've